Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. I know that you are expecting in this lesson to do the dashboard. But before diving into dashboard creations, we need to teach you some Excel tips and tricks. I collected for you the most commonly used Excel tips and tricks with a practice file, so you can study and be sure that you have the minimum skills required for any engineer or any active worker in the construction fields. Let me go through what I would like to tell you in this presentation. You should be aware of the Excel interface, how to formatting cells, freeze bands, using the formula plus, minus, multiply and division functions, how to use COUNTIF, how to make round, how to use IFERROR, how to use IFERROR, how to use VLOOKUP, how to use filters, and how to use slicers. You might ask yourself, Hani, this is project management course. Why you would like to teach us Excel? Because believe me, the time you are going to invest in learning these Excel skills will save you hundreds of working hours later on. So it is not something bonus, or it is something you might consider or not. It is something, to be honest, very, very essential. Because none of us, whether you are working on site or in office or head office, none of us will not use the reports or the dashboards. You might need to make a report even for yourself, not necessarily for your management. So you will find, if you don't know these skills already, you will find yourself struggling to do a simple task, doing it in several hours, while if you know a simple formula, you will save hundreds of working hours. So investing some hours to learn and master these Excel tips and tricks will definitely save for you very long working hours. So I provided for you the practice files. You will have the link below this video. You will find it. Two files. One file you are going to use in order to try to do all these steps. And the other file is a solved example after we did all these steps. So if you stuck in between, you can find what was wrong in your formulas or your things. So I was thinking to do a video of each one of these, but I preferred to give you a very detailed presentation. Also, you can download where you can find in the presentation a step-by-step guide will tell you what to do in every and single step, how to do everything. Why I prefer to have it as a presentation instead of video, because you need open the file and open the Excel together and try doing the steps. So here, if you don't know these skills, I recommend that you download the file from the link below and start doing your study. If you already are very good in Excel and you already know these skills, you can go directly to the dashboard creation. I'm going to show you what are in the presentation. So we started here with how to add workbook to your sheet, how to rename it, how to color it, how to, or a quick view of the ribbon in the Excel, how to make formatting, and also how to make your numbers, how to change the font size, color, text. Everything you need to know as basic information of the Excel, I started with it, how to make column alignment, and then we dive also in the decimals, how to make formatting cells. This is also examples in the sheets. I'll give you this one. I'm still asking you to do it like this. So how to make dates, how to make numbers, all of this one you should know. Definitely you should know, because this is the basic, and you cannot just bypass this one. How to make conditional format. This is very nice option to make colors of your cells and columns based on some conditional formats. You will love it, because if you are doing it in manual way, you will find that you are missing a lot. How to move the cell sheet from right to left or left to right. There are too many tips and tricks, but all of them are very essential for your skills. freezing bands, how you going to freeze your bands and start navigating through your Excel, how to use functions and formulas in Excel. It is very simple. Just follow the steps. You will find yourself very comfortable doing it. How to drag the formula, how to use COUNTIF. COUNTIF is very nice formula, which will count number of rows or columns based on some condition. We are going to use it, for example, in shop drawing count. So we count here the drawings where the status is only submitted. Imagine if you are doing it manually, you have to make filters and count them every time. But if you use the COUNTIF formula, you can simply do it with COUNTIF. Okay, so you will find it very nice here. Also, I'm showing to you the formula so you can make it easily and drag it and start modifying it. Also, I'm telling you how to make percentage of anything to make the percentage of shop drawing submittal. So this also included in the presentation. How to make a pie chart from a table. You can just select the table and start doing a pie chart. This will be used also in our dashboard. So then round is very useful when we are calculating the man hours and would like to know the average daily manpower. We need to make round up or maybe round down. Also, this formula is good. F formula is very, very powerful formula because it will give you some conditions you can apply. Like here, if the duration is more than 20, so we'll make it long, otherwise it will be short. So F formula also is very nice and you need to be practicing on it. F error also, if you have some errors in your formula, how to get rid of these errors using the F error. VLOOKUP is my best formula I'm using. So you need to learn VLOOKUP. It will also help you a lot. Let's say you have here some data which is the activity ID, but you don't have the activity name, and you have another sheet which has the activity name. How you are going to match between these two? Using VLOOKUP is very powerful formula, yet very simple. By the way, you can make a VLOOKUP here and find the relevant data and get it simply and dynamically, because if the source sheet anything changed, it will be changed here also. And this is a VLOOKUP formula. How to use the filters, because filters is very essential also. How to make data to a table and how to make filters in effective way. How to use numbers in your filter. This is also very powerful. And also the slicer. The slicer is something new in Excel, not very new, something that very powerful, where you can make slicer like this, and when you click on any of them, the data will be filtered according to your slicer. And once you finish all these skills, you will be definitely ready for creating your dashboard. So I hope you will go through the files and trying to practice by yourself. And once you finish, see you in the next lesson, where we are going to create our dashboard and enjoy what you have learned. Thank you very much. See you in the next lesson.